Hey guys, Maura here, and welcome to part four of my walkthrough of Word Detective at level two. I've already freed three agents, and I have nine more to free, so I'm just going to begin this case by transporting to my next location, Electro Vector's cave. Hey, look, there's the Vial logo on that item there. What is it, a storage unit, perhaps? Huh. Yay, another code breaker. Okay. I think I see two already. Boy. How do you say that? I don't think it's boy or buoy. And I see sauce. Is that a word? Yes, it is. I see wise. Aw, too bad it's not included. There's fart right there. Oh, there's revisit. Wow, that's quite a mouthful. I think that's the longest word on this list. There's ice. Floor. Gotta remember to look from diagonally as well as from right to left as well on this. Oh, there's rate. Lay off. Well, there's wrist. All right, fur. One thing I realized from doing Codebreaker when I got to level two in my first walkthrough is that since that will include, and level three will include longer words with more letters, the trick is to find as many of those first before focusing on words with fewer letters, like two or three. Although, you have to look very carefully because you could easily, what looks like one letter could be used to spell one word, it might be actually be need to be used to make another one close by. All right. Spellinizer, of course.
Physical. Alphabet.
Yes, every language has its own alphabet.
Dolphin.
Oh, I Captain has a pet dolphin. Huh. I wonder if, as bad as these villains are, do they actually love their pets? Well, Esther Odious seems to sure love her dog, even though it's a mean one.
Enough. Laugh.
Yes, she's got quite the laugh.
Rough. Caught.
Wow, that's quite an accomplishment.
Taught.
That's its stolen loot, I can see, or was starting to. Huh. I guess that means I'll get to see her on her motor, on her bike. I think I... When I played my first walkthrough at this level, I'm not sure if it at any time showed her doing that. I can't recall now how many times I visit each Crook's location. I think at least
either Carmen's
three times total, including when you
I'll check it out. You search for clues topside.
Take the keys. All right, look, and look here. There are some sandbags with Vio logo on them. Ah, micropics. Yeah, a memo from the desk of the chief. Yep, she was a star agent. I don't know if this is supposed to be connected to where in the world USA and time with Lynn Thigpen as the chief, but where in time is Carmen Sandiego? The end of that revealed that Carmen was one of Acme's brightest stars. Yeah, I remember this, this being in Rico Picks in level one. Oh, how did I, oh, so I mixed up the verbs. Well, they almost sound like they could, either one could work. Is that, okay, got you, that's what it says. Yeah, I mean, I was saying the body of this exercise in the text looks the same as it was in level one, but there's some alterations, some changes. Cracked another one of your codes. Titan security villains, or you're working a desk job at Moe's Crime Emporium. Ooh, she sounds mad. Yeah, I think I can conclude that Spellinizer is the one that, I mean, notice like that I've moved up to the level, so the types of, even though I've moved up to the level, the only thing that changes are, you know, addition of letters down here and what the exercises lay out for the player, but the overall, what happens within the game itself, that doesn't change. Like events and what types of exercises you have to do at each villain's hideout. No, all the changes in this are what the exercises give the player. So I know this may seem, playing this again may seem like a repeat since nothing changes in
anywhere.
Terms of the sequence of events with Carmen and her crooks and Carmen and Chase's messages to the player, but I wanted to do it again just to see what differences it could bring with these exercises. I like to try something different. Clues could be anywhere, Chase says. Yes, they can.
Somewhat.
Yeah, barely spoke a whisper. Yeah, I think she's She doesn't. She'll shout her plans out to the world because she is difficult to catch. So she's not. She thinks she's like. Well, she can flee the law, that she doesn't hide what crime she's pulling next, because she thinks she's invincible since she can't easily be apprehended by Acme.
Change. Chocolate. Crunch.
I'm not sure what this is spelling out. I want to try to interpret these messages as much as possible, but I don't know what this is spelling out. And just, hey, whenever you guys comment, if anything like that, if you want to help me interpret some of these messages or to anything of that nature, I mean, feel free to comment. I like getting comments. I want to hear your thoughts, like...
August.
Okay, one another word that has to be capitalized because it's a month, which has to be a noun that must be capitalized at all times.
Dinosaur.
I think since doing this at level 2, Spellinizer has also given me January as a word that is capitalized as a noun that's capitalized by default. I think the only time that there was a capitalized word at level 1 was Halloween. Alright, time to grab the keys. Easily loses his his balance and footing. Such a clumsy, oafish captain. All right, now free the agent.
Whoa! Now that's more like it. I have to hand it to you. It took guts to sneak back in here again. Here's what I found out before I was caught. My job is done here, but you still have your work cut out for you. Good luck.
All right, so you said connecting the continents with computer
nice
cables
going,
under the ocean floor.
While you were cracking those clues, I found out that Carmen's been connecting the continents with computer cables under the ocean floor. It must have something to do with her master plan for the Babylon machine. Ready or not, here's your next mission.
Okay, well, I'll save that for the next video. And now, as you can see, since I finished the first 4 cases, now my password decoder has been upgraded to 5 places. So here it ends, part 4 of my walkthrough of Word Detective at level 2. I hope you guys enjoyed this, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.